وسلم على رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه الهادين المهديين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد وفرقان الحميد يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله العظيم قال الله تعالى في شان حبيبه مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما صلوا على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم All praises to Allah, the Almighty, the only eternal being worthy of worship. Peace and blessings, salawat and salam be upon our Savior, our Master, Ahmad-e-Mujtaba, Muhammad-e-Mustafa, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Dear respected ulama and shayukh, my respected elders, brothers, and guests, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is a fact that every moment, every second, every minute, every hour, every moment, day or night, spent in the remembrance and the submission of Allah the Almighty and His beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is exceedingly meaningful and very, very precious. But there are some days, some months that have their own status and rank. Amongst the months, we have the blessed month of Sha'ban and the holy month of Ramadan. Sha'ban is a meritorious month, the month of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. One is ordered to prepare himself for Ramadan in Sha'ban. We are ordered to welcome Ramadan in the holy month of Sha'ban. The blessed month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed in. It is the time of tremendous blessings. On the authority of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, reported in Sahih Bukhari, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, O people, Ramadan has come to you and Allah has prescribed you to fast. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in Ramadan, the gates of paradise are open and the gates of the hellfire are shut. It has also been reported that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in Ramadan, the devils are chained. They are put in chains. My dear respected brothers, Ramadan is the month of the Quran. It has great excellences over every single other month. The Quran and Sunnah has testified this. The month of Ramadan is the month of Quran in regards to revelation and the study of the Quran. Allah the Almighty said in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed in. On the authority of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Sayyiduna Jibreel alayhi salam would descend and come and meet the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam every single night of Ramadan. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would study the Quran with Jibreel alayhi salam. He would do door. He would read his manzil. He would read the Quran to Jibreel alayhi salam every single night of Ramadan. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, reported by Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, this month of Ramadan is also known as the month of Qiyam. Qiyamul Layl, to stand in the voluntary night prayer. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Man qama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lah ma taqaddama min dhanbih. Whosoever stands in Ramadan with faith and with the niyyah, with the intention to seek rewards, then the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, all his previous sins will be forgiven. Sins are forgiven in the month of Ramadan. Rewards are multiplied. Fasting itself is a shield. The servant on the day of judgment, he will use the shield to protect himself from the hellfire. On the day of judgment, fasting will say, O my Lord, I have prevented him from eating and drinking. I have not let him fulfill his desires, so accept my intercession for him. And this is a beautiful hadith reported by Imam Hakim in his Al-Mustadrak. And Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal has also reported this in his Al-Musnad. There is a gate in paradise. It is called Ar-Rayyan. Only those who had fasted will enter through this gate into paradise. It is truly encouraging to know that the doors of repentance are always open. But Allah is actually happy when His servant repents. The importance and significance of repentance is that the sinner must desert away from the sin. He must move away from the sin. He must not commit the sin again. And he should feel regret for perpetrating it. He should make a firm resolve not to commit the sin again. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, O people, repent to Allah, for indeed I repent to Allah 100 times every single day. This has been reported in Tirmidhi. A beautiful story at the time of Musa alayhi salam. Prophet Musa alayhi salam and the people of Bani Israel, they embarked a journey and they camped at a desert. The heat and the humidity increased and they experienced a drought. Prophet Musa alayhi salam and the people of Bani Israel, they decided to collectively pray to Allah so he could bestow his mercy upon them in the form of rain. So when they prayed to Allah, Allah the Almighty, he responded and he said to Musa alayhi salam, you have a person in your congregation who has sinned all his life. He has sinned for 40 years until he does not separate himself from the congregation. I will not bestow my mercy in the form of rain. So Prophet Musa alayhi salam, he informed the congregation. He told them that there is one person amongst us who has sinned all his life. Until he does not separate himself from the congregation, Allah will not bless his mercy. So people waited, and there was this man. He waited for someone to come forward. He looked right and he looked left, but no one came forward. No one separated from the congregation. So he knew it was him, sweating from toe to head, and his tears were flowing down both his cheeks. And he decided to repent to Allah. He raised his hands and he said to Allah, today with sincerity and humility, I seek forgiveness. Please forgive my sins and do not expose me in front of people. It came to Prophet Musa alayhi salam's astonishment that the clouds in the sky, they got together and it began to rain. Prophet Musa alayhi salam, he asked Allah the Almighty, he said, no one has separated from the congregation, but you still bestowed your mercy upon us. Allah responded, he said, O Musa, the same person that I requested you, I ordered you, for him to separate himself from the congregation, he seeked forgiveness from me. He repented in my court with sincerity and humility. Prophet Musa alayhi salam was amazed. He said to Allah, he requested, he said, I want to see this person. I want to meet this person. Allah the Almighty responded, he replied, O Musa, he had sinned for 40 years and I had never exposed him. And today he has sought forgiveness. He has repented in my court. Do you think I will expose him? My dear respected elders and brothers, there is no better time than this in welcoming Ramadan and repenting in the court of Allah the Almighty, the most merciful, the all-forgiving, all-knowing, all-hearing. We are all sinners. Repentance in Islam is free of charge. There is no cost. It is absolutely free. We are all sinners. The question is there any one of us who is innocent of sins? The answer is a big no. We are all sinners, but we hope to be amongst those who repent. Reported in Tirmidhi, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every son of Adam alayhi salam is a sinner, but the best among those the sinners is the one who repents in the court of Allah the Almighty. My dear respected elders and brothers, I have limited time and my prime focus is on repentance, and there is no other better time than welcoming Ramadan and building a spiritual momentum to worship Allah, to reconnect directly with Allah the Almighty. Let's revive our faith. Let's turn to Allah the Almighty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this beautiful gathering organized by YQNC. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower His blessings and mercy upon this congregation. May Allah the Almighty, the most merciful, give us the ability, give us the strength, give us the courage to honor Ramadan. May Allah give us the courage to honor the Quran. Lastly, I humbly but strictly request everyone to welcome the best month of the year. Let's renew our faith. Let's revive our faith. Let's turn to Allah. Let's repent in the court of Allah the Almighty. According to Ubadah ibn As-Samit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the great companion of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would welcome Ramadan in such words, Allahumma sallimni li Ramadan wa sallim Ramadan wa sallimhu minhu mutaqabbalan. O Allah, save and greet Ramadan for me. Save and greet Ramadan. Save and greet Ramadan on my behalf and grant me its acceptance. May Allah the Almighty give us the courage to honor the holy month of Ramadan. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.